17th chapter, The Threefold Faith, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas.
My Lord, those who do acts of sacrifice, not according to the scriptures, but nevertheless with implicit faith, what is their condition? Is it one of purity, of passion, or of ignorance?
O greatest of archers, man has an inherent faith in one or the other of the qualities. Purity, passion, ignorance, sattva, rajas, tamas. The faith of every man conforms to his nature. By nature, he is full of faith. He is in fact what his faith makes him. The pure worship the true God. The passionate, the powers of wealth and magic. On the other hand, the ignorant worship the spirits of the dead and of the lower orders of nature. Those who practice austerities not commanded by the scriptures, who are slaves to hypocrisy and egotism, who are carried away by the fury of desire and passion, they are ignorant. They torment the organs of the body and they harass me, who lives within. Know that, O Arjun, they are devoted to evil. The food which men enjoy is also threefold, like the ways of sacrifice, austerity, and gifting. Listen to the distinction. The foods that prolong life and increase purity, vigor, health, cheerfulness and happiness are those that are delicious, soothing, substantial and agreeable. These are loved by the pure, the sattvic. Those in whom passion, rajas, is dominant, like foods that are bitter, sour, salty, spicy, pungent, dry and burning. These foods produce unhappiness, sorrow and disease. The ignorant, tamasic, love food which is stale, not nourishing, putrid and corrupt, the leavings of others and unclean. Sacrifice is pure, O Arjun, when it is offered by one who does not desire the fruits thereof, when it is done according to the commands of the scriptures and with implicit faith that the sacrifice is a duty. Sacrifice which is performed for the sake of his results or for self-glorification, that, O best of Aryans, is the product of passion. Then, sacrifice that is contrary to scriptural command, that is, unaccompanied by prayers or gifts of food or money, and is performed without faith, that sacrifice is a product of ignorance. Worship of God and the Master, respect for the preacher and the philosopher, purity, morally correct behavior, self-control, and harmlessness. All this is physical austerity. Speech that hurts no one, that is true, is pleasant to listen to and beneficial. And the constant study of the scriptures, this is austerity in speech. Serenity, kindness, silence, self-control, and purity. This is austerity of mind. These threefold austerities performed with faith and without thought of reward may truly be accounted as pure. Austerity, coupled with hypocrisy, or performed for the sake of self-glorification, popularity, or vanity, comes from passion, and its result is always doubtful and temporary. Austerity done under delusion and accompanied with sorcery or torture to oneself or another may be assumed to spring from ignorance. The gift which is given without a sense of compensation, in the belief that it ought to be made, in a fit place, at an opportune time, and to a deserving person, such a gift is pure. A gift which is given for the sake of the results it will produce, or with some hope of recompense or ulterior motive, or grudgingly, that may truly be the outcome of passion. And that gift which is given at an unsuitable place or time, or to one who is unworthy, or given with disrespect or contempt, such a gift is the result of ignorance. Om Tat Sat. This is a triple designation of the Eternal Spirit, the principle mentioned in the ancient Vedic scriptures, by which the ceremonials and the sacrifices were to be made. Therefore, all acts of sacrifice, gifts and austerities performed by those who understand the Spirit begin with the word Om. Those who desire deliverance begin their acts of sacrifice, austerity or gift with the word Tat, meaning that, without thought of reward. Sat means reality, or the highest good, and also, O Arjun, it is used to mean an action of exceptional merit. Conviction in sacrifice, in austerity, and in giving is also called Sat. So too, an action done only for the Lord's sake. Whatsoever is done without faith, whether it be sacrifice, austerity or gift or anything else, is called asat, meaning unreal, for it is the negation of sat. O Arjun, such an act has no significance here or hereafter.
Thus, in the holy book, the Bhagavad Gita, one of the Upanishads, in the science of the Supreme Spirit, in the art of self-knowledge, in the dialogue between the Divine Lord Shri Krishna and Prince Arjun, stands the 17th chapter, the Threefold Faith, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas.